talk a little bit about what was it opened up this path. St. Paul says in chapter 12, verse 15 of his letter to the Romans, rejoice with those who rejoice, and alegrarse con los que están alegres, y lloren con los que lloran, and weep with those who weep. Vivan en armonía unos con otros, live in harmony one with the other. No quieran sobresalir, don't look for a kind of time like he, the most visible, or to push ourselves in front of everybody else. Pónganse a la altura de los más humildes. Put yourself together with the most humble. This is his exhortation to the whole church. Pónganse a la altura de los más humildes. Y no presuman de sabios. And don't have so much confidence in your own wisdom. He's talking to the whole church, and I think it's a good scripture for us to kind of pray for a spirit, a certain attitude as followers of Jesus, as St. Paul was, but also as members of the community of the baptized, the life and the body of the church. Que esta es la actitud de un cristiano católico buscando el camino de Jesús. Alegrense con los que están alegres y lloren por los que lloran. That we take on the attitude of Christ in some way to hear, first of all, the joys of each other, and to hear also the tears. I use this because it kind of opens up the path of what the Holy Father is asking of the whole church right now, and that we are going to find our way, como iglesia pequeña, ¿no? Punto más al sur del estado de Texas, like the little church that we are. But it's a beautiful thing to be the little church that we are, in the southernmost part of Texas, because we have this already this sense of being not with an attitude of presumption, but of listening and of putting ourselves in the position of the humble, which is what St. Paul is asking us. And so I use this scripture because it kind of gives us kind of the big panorama. What the Holy Father is asking the church is to take this moment in time after COVID, or as COVID is kind of moving forward in a different way now, but it's still very strong in many parts of the world. And after many sorrows that we've suffered, but also many hopes, to kind of take on and renew our commitment to walk together. No, que tiene que ver con buscar el camino de caminar juntos. And the Holy Father is asking the whole church to kind of remember very basically that to walk together, we have to learn again how to hear each other. Es un aprendizaje, no, it's a learning. And so rather than say, well, right now, well, this is what the goal is, and this is what we're going to do when all this is over, en lugar de proponer inmediatamente este programa con que vamos a terminar el proceso, antes de hacer eso, before our agendas, before our what we think, you know, ought to be the program after all this is, we go through this period of sin, this worldwide sin, before that, we need to learn again how to hear each other. I think the Holy Father is particularly attentive to the fact that the world today, the world even throughout the world, Christian and not Christian, is often talking at each other. There's much rancor. There's a lot of hurt in the world. And como digo, a veces es el mundo, a veces despierta cada mañana de mal humor. The world kind of wakes up in a bad mood. And then to begin a healing, which I think is the work of the church, especially a healing that the gospel itself calls us to be able to be joyful with those who are joyful and to weep with those who weep. But to do that, we have to know what they're joyful about and what their hopes are, or our hopes are, and what our tears are about. Hablando del mundo, ¿no? Y también de la iglesia, que también tenemos eso. This particular sort of passage of St. Paul has an echo that is echoed later in the Second Vatican Council, and Pope Francis is very much wanting us to kind of re-attend to them with new vigor in this world we're living in now. Oh, to kind of one of the things that the Second Vatican Council called the body of the Church to, because it's not invitando al Papa bajo la luz del Evangelio de pensar de nuevo sobre este sentimiento básico de la Iglesia en el Concilio Vaticano. And so I just want you to, I'm going to reference here, go back. I think one of the things we can do during these next several months is kind of go back, and I would encourage us to kind of slowly meditate on a long document, but it's the Constitution on the Church in the Modern World, not the Gaudium et Spes. The Papa tiene esto, the Pope has this in mind, that we should, and it's there, you can, on the internet, you can find it. Because the opening of that particular document is, it's the joys and the sorrows, the preoccupations and the worries of the world today are the joys and the sorrows and the preoccupations of the disciples of Jesus. That's how that whole document starts that way. No, las alegrías y las tristezas, las esperanzas del mundo son las alegrías y las tristezas y las esperanzas del discípulo de Cristo. But how do we know this if we do not hear it? Then we have to re-sintonizarnos, no? We sort of synchronize our hearing to kind of what our people. And so this is a worldwide thing. Nosotros no nos vamos a preocupar lo que están haciendo en Europa tanto o en África, sino que nuestro rebaño aquí está. And our responsibility is to kind of look at our world, our church, our people, our wider community, not just the believers, and to hear the joys and the sorrows and the hopes. Because we believe that underneath sometimes the world is sometimes in a bad mood, no, que este mundo de mal humor, que debajo de todo eso existen cosas más profundas, there are deeper things. And the only way we're going to get over the resentments and the anger is if we listen to the deeper things, las alegrías y las esperanzas, the joys and the hopes, las tristezas, which are different today than they were when the Second Vatican Council was writing Gaudium et Spes, and we have to kind of be attentive to what our people and the work of the Synod. So what are we going to do? Well, the most things, we're going to find ways to listen to each other. And you who are delegates, and I'm so glad to see you here, is that we're going to think together, we're going to give you a little experience this morning as to kind of how this might work. But to think together as to how we can invite our own people to listen. Con calma. See, we live in a world where somebody starts talking and immediately we want to interrupt. No? No. And so perhaps, la disciplina del sínodo es escuchar y decir, ah, sí, pero qué. Hear. ¿Qué dijo el Señor tantas veces en la mañana? Que tengo oídos que oigan. That he was here, hear. Because the mystery of the gospel is that we will never see if we don't know how to listen. We will never see the moment, we will never understand the moment we're living in our own communities if we don't listen to our people. Entonces es un aprendizaje de camino. No, it's a learning through this world. So today, I want you just to kind of tranquilos, so we don't have to plan everything for the next year. We just right now, the moment is we need to learn to spend all time listening and thinking, and how and can we help people who never get a chance to say anything and sometimes feel rejected because porque muchos dicen no, pues ni los políticos ni la iglesia les quiero escuchar, neither the politicians or the church wants to hear me. So who's that? Pues aquí el testimonio es que la iglesia quiere escuchar. Y la iglesia somos nosotros. No, somos solamente. It's not just the bishop and the bishop. No, no. This is the thing. Es todo el cuerpo de Cristo como una comunión, abriendo sus corazones y sus oídos. And so we're going to want to think about how we're going to invite people to have confidence that they will be heard. Nada más, porque hay una sanación There is a healing in letting someone speak without interrupting them. Because that's already a sign that they are respected. Poder escuchar sin constantemente pensar en cómo interrumpir. No, yo sé mejor. No, como dije, lo digo pasado, ¿no? Que la muchedumbre desciende del cielo al cielo, ya cállate. Like in the Gospel last Sunday, the crowd told him, "Why, man, be quiet, shut up. We don't want to hear, we do want to hear." Porque Jesús, instruyendo a los discípulos, dijo, "Ya, man, I want to hear." Well, so we're going to talk a little bit about that, con calma, no? Because I think if we can, because it's not so much that at the end of this we're going to have a lot of information and will, because we're going to try to keep a record here and kind of, and we're going to go through it as just stuff to do after we do this process of listening. We'll do that. And even though that's important, what's important is that along the way we maybe get a little bit better at hearing each other. Okay, we'll cambio dentro. Con escuchar al otro. Anyway. Este camino de escuchar las alegrías y las esperanzas. And to start thinking about how we can look for the people who do not have a voice. I'm thinking of the poor. I'm thinking of the young adult. I'm thinking of the young person who's maybe on the edge. Las periferias on the edge. And you have ears. And we will learn a little bit how to listen to each other. But also, part of what this is about is how you can then say, how can we go out to people and ask them to speak about their hopes and their fears? This is the call. That's what the people did when they came to Jesus. What did they say to him? What were their hopes? And what were their fears? Tengan fe. En la cercanía del Señor. Jesus is with us on this. Okay. So this, so I want us to kind of spend some time doing this and just reference for you also, I've already referenced this second back of council, I think I this because it's very important. And that we look, esta es la obra de todos. This is not the bishop's work, and this is not the pope's work, this is our work. Para superar este espíritu, aquí por su lado. Overcome this spirit that kind of divides and that is always arguing and so, but that we're together because we have something great in common, and that is our communion and the baptism that the Lord has given to us. Y que venimos juntos a la Señora. And then the other thing I ask you to meditate on the days to come as we look and think about these things is what the Holy Father talked about in Evangelii Gaudium, the joy of the gospel. That is, he dreams of a church where everything is focused on the mission of announcing Christ. La misión ya tenemos, announcing Christ. So, why are we listening? So we hear where people are living. And why do we want to hear? Because we love them. Because Jesus loves them. And then to bring something of Christ to them and to us. It's not like we have something that we're going to give, pero que todos vamos a compartir esto. We're all going to live this. Con humildad, escuchar, to rejoice with those who are joyful, and to weep with those who weep, and there is much weeping. So don't be surprised if you're going to do the group. No, that some things are going to come out, because you give people permission to speak, and they will tell you. It's a vulnerable spot to be. Your ears are vulnerable to what people will think. Did that happen? It's the vulnerability of Christ to hear. So I'm thankful for this organization, and I've already thanked you for being here, but we have a long road to go, pero vamos juntos, entonces sí vamos a llegar. So thank you very much, and I'll pass this on back to Nicolás.